Strong. So, Riley, can you think of something that makes us strong?
Playing games.
Playing games? Yeah. In our house, we play a lot of games to help us, you know, get strong, have strong muscles. So, do you want to show the kids one of the games that we play?
Okay.
You want to show them the Move It game?
The Move It
game. Okay, this game is called, what do we call it? We called it the Move It Name Game. So how you play this game is I have a paper that has all the letters of the alphabet, and each letter in the alphabet has a different exercise. And so we're going to spell Riley's name, and she will show you how we do it, and then maybe we can get a close-up of the sheet, and you could try it at home. Okay, so for letter R, you have to walk like a bear. So can you show the kids how you walk like a bear? So you put your hands down on the ground, keep your knees up.
My owner's Shawn Brave.
Yeah, Riley likes to pretend to be Princess Brave. I don't know if you've ever seen that movie, but it helps when you're exercising to pretend. Good job, Riley. Okay, you did letter R.
Good job, Brave.
Good job, Brave. What comes next in your name?
I.
Okay, so for letter I, you have to balance on your foot. So can you hold one foot up, and I'm gonna count to 10. You ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And your name?
Ow!
Okay, let's see. Now you have to pretend like you're jumping for 5 jumps. You think you can do that? Can I help you jump? Okay, so we gotta count to 5. You ready? So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, let's show the kids your name. You've done letter R. And you've done letter I, you've done letter L. What comes next?
E!
Okay, let's check. For letter E, oh my goodness. You have to walk like a bear again. Can you do it?
Queen Honor's gonna help, right?
All right, you got it, Princess Brave.
Oh man,
try again. In the snow. Get your knees up. All right, walk like a bear. Good job! Good job, Princess Bridge! What's the last letter in your name?
Y!
And you have to walk on your knees. Up, up, up! Come on, Rye! Okay, ready? Oh, get your balance. Flip! Ready? Now walk on your knees! You got it! I'll hold you up. There you go! What do you think you need after all that working out? Do you need a drink of water? Get your water. Get your water. Oh, man. All that working out. You want to bring it over here?
Can we get chocolate?
Oh, yeah, chocolate. Chocolate is a very good motivator, too, isn't it? Here, let's sit here. Oh, okay. We'll take a little break after all that exercising, huh? Want to show the kids this? So, we've been talking this month about joy, right? And how the joy of the Lord is our strength. So how do we get strong like that verse is talking about? We don't really do exercises, right? That makes our body strong. Playing games like that, that'll make your muscles strong. But how do we get strong in Jesus? It's just as simple and as huge as hanging out with him. So how can we hang out with Jesus? We've talked about this before. You can pray. That's just talking to Jesus. And also, you can read your Bible. Do you guys have a Bible at home? This is Riley's. It's called the Storybook Bible. And we like reading this a lot. When do we usually read this? Do you remember?
At night,
yep, before you go to bed usually. So it's really fun to, you know, snuggle and read, and Riley really likes stories, and the Bible is just one really big story all about God's love for you. It's full of stories. So there's a lot of fun stories in here to read, and so we've been reading these before Riley takes a nap or before bed. But something that we've been doing recently that has made Bible reading even more fun is we've been acting out the stories. So around Easter time, one of the stories that Riley really liked, let's find it to show him, was this one. What's happening in this story, Rye?
It's stepping stuff.
They step in stuff, yeah. This is a story about Jesus and his friends. Oh my goodness, yeah. And Riley likes that part of the story. This is a story about Jesus and his friends, and Jesus's friends, they wore, sit with me. What did they wear on their feet?
Sandals.
They wore sandals, and they would walk everywhere. And so their feet would get dirty from all the dirt on the road. And Riley's favorite part, even, what did they step in sometimes?
Cow poop, or donkey poop, or camel poop,
huh? So their feet would be all stinky and dirty. So when they would come to dinner, they would wash not only their hands, but what else would they have to wash?
Their feet.
Their feet, because it was all stinky. So they didn't want to have stinky feet before they eat. So let's show them this page. Who washes Jesus' friend's feet in this story?
Jesus!
Let's show the picture. You want to hold it up? So usually it was a servant's job to wash the stinky, dirty feet, huh? But in this story, Jesus, he did that job. He washed his friend's feet. And at first his friends were a little bit embarrassed. They said, "Oh man, Jesus, I have really stinky feet. You can't wash my feet." But you know what Jesus said? He said, "I do this because I love you." And so Riley really liked that story. She liked reading it a lot. And so one night around Easter time, we tried washing each other's feet. You want to show them how we did that? So Riley's going to pretend to be...
Who are you pretend to be?
Peter! Peter! One of Jesus' friends. And I'll pretend to be Jesus. And so in the story, Jesus had his friends sit down and he took off their sandals. And so I'm going to take off your shoe, Rye.
You're using your shoe to be like your sandal.
Yeah, you can pretend this is like your sandal. And then I'll just show everybody, just in case they were wondering, these are called braces. Riley wears these on her feet, and what do they help you do?
Walk.
They help her walk. So if you ever wondered, she usually picks purple ones. You can pick the color. But I'll show you, in case you ever wondered what they look like. That's what they look like. Kind of like another shoe that goes on her foot first, and then we put it in her shoe, huh? And then underneath her brace and her shoe, she has?
A sock.
A sock and?
Feet.
A foot. Feet, just like you guys. And oh, do they smell?
Oh my goodness.
Cow poop.
Did you step in cow poop?
Yeah. Oh,
we gotta wash those feet, huh, Peter? So Jesus had a bowl or a bucket, and he put his friend's feet in there, and he got them all clean.
Peter said, whoa.
And Peter said, whoa, huh? And then what did Jesus say? Do you remember? He said, "I do this because
I love you."
I love you. That was Jesus' message for his friends. And guess what? That's his message for you. He loves you. So maybe this week, maybe you want to try that move it name game. And then after you get all tired, maybe you want to sit down and read one of your Bible stories, and maybe you and your family could act one out this week. If you do, tell us about it. Tell us which story you guys acted out. Ask your whole family to do it. Riley's dada plays a great donkey. He's been several donkeys in the story. So ask everybody to help. It'll be a blast. And just want to let you guys know, we love you.
Peter's foot is all clean.
All clean, Peter.
What's a hot dog's favorite hairstyle? A bun. Wah, wah, wah.
What can you always count on when everything else goes wrong? Your fingers.
Why didn't unicorns make it onto the ark? I don't know.
What makes an octopus laugh? Tentacles.
How do fish pay for toys?
$10.
$10.